Good morning. Tare Social is proud to invite Dr. Prem Narasimhan today for his talk on incontinence for seniors. Over on to you, Doctor.
Loss, hygiene, but also it will lead to something known as loss of independence. It can also lead to social embarrassment. And ultimately, it will cause a negative impact on the quality of life as far as an older adult is concerned. So what are the symptoms usually of urinary incontinence? Incontinence can obviously be of various types. One is, of course, urge incontinence. So when the older adult will get an urge, the time to go to the toilet, they will not be able to tolerate. This is very common in older adults, especially males. Then stress incontinence is very common in females, in which we know that they have actually all the organs in a female body are quite crammed up, and they also have to undergo considerable pressure as compared to loss of muscle tone due to repeated pregnancies. Then also, once the menopause sets in, then the hormones go. There is a chance that the pelvic muscles, which are down, they get weaker, and then they lose tone. So on coughing and sneezing or laughing, sometimes the urine will be lost. Then there is something known as overflow incontinence, in which there will be dribbling of urine. And also, as urge incontinence, as I said, is very common in males, especially it's in prostate, because prostate is, as we go older, the size can increase. Then, of course, the other types of incontinence, which include something known as mixed. So a person can have a mixture of urge as well as stress incontinence both. Then there is also a very important type, which is known as the functional incontinence. Now, functional incontinence is something which can happen to anybody. In an older adult, for some reason, or for us also mentally, for example, if we go to a public place and then we are not wanting to use the public toilet, or we want to go elsewhere, we want to wait to go to our surroundings so that we can actually go comfortably. So when that happens, it can obviously lead to a bladder getting full and also causing incontinence. So that is something we need to obviously take care of. Now, why do we care about incontinence? Now, the reason we care of incontinence is because it causes a very significant impact, as I told you, on a quality of life of the older adult. For the thought that they might actually lose their independence, the fact that what happens if they go to public and they lose control over their urine itself makes them mentally down. So that's why we need to be very, very wary of incontinence. Incontinence, again, is something which is not a part of aging. So there are a lot of causes, like if you have repeated acute incontinence, then it could be because of urinary infection. Then prostate is one. Then, as I said, in females, stress incontinence can happen, repeated surgeries in the abdomen. So there is reason. So aging is not the factor where everybody will have incontinence, because a lot of older adults have a real taboo in actually telling the doctor. One is they might think that it is a part of aging, and second is it is an embarrassing kind of thing that I actually lose. I mean, a person who has been independent loses control on his own urine. So that becomes slightly embarrassing as far as an older adult is concerned. So we as doctors, as healthcare providers, have to ask leading questions. So we ask questions like, have you lost urine? How many times have you lost in the past 1 week? Or is it happening every day? And then slowly and steadily, as the patient opens up, the patient is able to tell us that, yeah, they are having a significant problem. And why? We need to know the cause of the problem and try to treat it, because this is something which should never be neglected. Then what are the things which will always be in your mind? For example, if you're diabetic, newly caused diabetic, then you will have to go urine again and again. Then what are the types of incontinence? What type of specialist? Of course, I would say you can obviously see me, a geriatrician or a general practitioner first, and then let us decide whether you need a urologist or not, because not every type of incontinence will need a urologist intervention. Then the common question that an older adult asks is whether with medication it can improve. Yeah, certain types of incontinences, they do improve. But medications are also causing incontinence. So for example, if you are a heart patient and you have diuretics like Lasix and all, and then you take it in the night, we never usually prescribe it. If you take it by mistake in the night, then the entire night you will be passing urine. And the problem is what can happen is you might actually fall in your own urine and that causes fall. So that is something we will never want to actually take. Then things like caffeine, taking too much of tea, cold drinks, alcohol, these are also things that can increase the chance of incontinence. Then your fluid intake, I think, is very important. So if you take around 1 to 1.5 liters a day, it is good enough for your age. If you have certain conditions like heart, kidney, then of course, depending upon the doctor and depending upon your advice, you might have to limit your fluid intake. Please always make sure that your fluid intake is limited as far as after 6 p.m. is concerned. I can understand you might have multiple medications. So whatever you need, if you have to cover around 1.2 or 1.4 liters, try to cover that throughout the day before 6 p.m. And after 6 p.m., just try to take a bit, maybe one or two glasses, so that you don't have to go to urine again and again. Now, there is obviously a theory behind that. As you're younger, you don't have to, I mean, even if you remember, if you had drank a lot of water, then you don't need to always get up in the night and go. But as you grow older, you might have to go multiple times. The reason being, there is something known as nephron. Nephron is a unit of the kidney, and they work very hard to filter the urine. That is to take out all the waste outside. So as we grow older, the kidney is also growing older. So the number of nephrons working are also older and are lesser. So if we drink more water after 6 p.m., we are making them work more hard. So they will have to work more in the night as well as in the day. So then we will have to, obviously, we'll have to end up going again and again. Then, of course, there are certain surgical treatments as well. Of course, a urologist would be the best person to say what all treatments. But as far as the prostate is concerned, we always try to start treatment with medications. And then, of course, depending upon your symptoms, which include increase in passing urine, urgency, hesitancy, when you go, you have to come back and you want to go again. Then fluid intake, I think, as I told you, should not be very less also, because if you have dehydration, then that can lead to your urinary tract infection. And ultimately, that can obviously cause you to lose your, my most important thing is you lose your self-confidence. Now, as caregivers, it is not easy to take care of people with incontinence. So it's your responsibility, I would say, to know what it is. So read about it, ask the provider, healthcare provider, to tell you in detail what it is. And your goals as a caregiver is, if the urinary incontinence is too much, you obviously have to get him or her evaluated by a healthcare provider. Even if you think the problem seems to be very small, then everything can be trained. So our bladder also can be trained. So the bathroom, number of times the bathroom trips are, we have to reduce it and make sure that the person, older adult, is able to train their bladder to pass maybe in particular frequency rather than going again and again. Then, of course, there are certain exercises for the lower pelvic floor, which are known as Kegels exercises. Now, in case of stress incontinence, they help in strengthening the muscle floor and reduce the chances of incontinence. Please, always, your diet and fluid intake is something which you have to take into consideration and which should always be something which you closely monitor. Then another important thing is constipation. Remember, the more constipation you have, the more pressure from the heart stool, there is more chance of that your urinary incontinence will get worsened. So you have to make sure that you don't have constipation. Now, when do we have to? The biggest question is, when do you want to go or contact the healthcare provider? One is sudden loss of inability to pass urine. So, for example, if it happens suddenly, you have great difficulty in passing urine. Then you have blood in urine. Please call if you have these issues, and then we will obviously try to make sure that whose help you need, whether you need our help or whether you need the healthcare provider. Other, for example, urologist or maybe even a gynecologist. In females, I think a gynecologist assessment for urinary incontinence is always important, because as females grow old, the hormones reduce and there is obviously increased dryness as well. So that can obviously lead to more chances of infection and also urinary incontinence because of that. try to maintain a bladder diary. So however, whenever you are passing, how many times you are passing urine, how many times if it has actually gone into your underwear or clothing, how much urine you have passed, then how many times you will have to go. A record generally tells us that how many times you have to go, and then how, for example, if you lose urine through coughing, sneezing, then we can obviously sort of know. Then always your drugs you should bring with, not only for incontinence, because we need to check the side effects. We need to see which drug might be causing an interaction, and then sort of the incontinence might take place. Then setting up a bladder schedule. By that, I mean, once we know the diary, we know we'll have to say strategies. So for example, we'll be like, no, now the bladder has to be trained for passing urine every 2 hours. And we have to support as a caregiver to you so that we can obviously help you in controlling that particular urine. Now, what is important is urinary incontinence in people with cognitive impairment or dementia, it becomes difficult for them to actually remember. But constant coaxing, constant reminding them to go whenever they have to go to the toilet, and assistive them can make sure, of course, clothing and hygiene can be taken care of. Then as far as diapers are concerned, I would say diapers, never feel that they are actually making you dependent. The reason being, we did a study in Ames where we had done a study for urinary incontinence, and we sort of realized that when we asked the older adults, they were like, if the doctor feels that we need a diaper, then we are ready to use it. Now, why I'm saying is, if because of the diaper, you are able to go out and then you are able to actually enjoy the normal time which you were able to do, then it is actually a boon. Never see it as a bane, because ultimately, if you are restricted to home and you're not able to continue your social activities because of urinary incontinence, then that can obviously make you really mentally down. Then control your diet. As I told you, no caffeine, no cola, no tea, amount of fluid intake. Too little is bad, too more is bad. Then always, we don't need to rely on pads. As you said, if you're going on long trips, obviously try to take a break where you can actually go in. And I'll also want to encourage the Kegel exercises. Kegel exercises are something which will help you in strengthening your lower muscles. Of course, any physiotherapist, a gynecologist will be able to explain to you that the lower pelvic muscles have to be contracted and the stomach relaxes during this exercises. Then it takes time for these exercises to work, because you have to make sure that your lower abdominal becomes obviously more and more strong. Then some takeaway points are, please do not be embarrassed to talk about your incontinence with any doctor. I know it can be a bit of a loss of self-confidence, loss of confidence. Oh my God, I actually am losing control. The reason being, there are medical ways also. Maybe it's diabetes. If we treat diabetes, your incontinence will be better. If it is because of some blood pressure medication, then we tackle that, that will be better. So that's how, if we are able to know treatable conditions, we will obviously be able to. Now, what is important is, in incontinence always, is that we have to continue monitoring, because whatever plan we gave might fail. If that is the case, then we don't want you to continue to have incontinence, as I told you, and fall in your own urine and have a fall. That is something we really don't want. So usually a multidisciplinary consultation or a intervention, including a geriatrician along with a urologist and a gynecologist, plus minus if at all we need any other surgical intervention, have to be used for tackling urinary incontinence. Because again, urinary incontinence is not a part of normal aging. It has its causes, and we need to sort of tackle it the right way. Thank you everyone for your patient hearing. This was just a brief on urinary incontinence and common questions asked. You can take a moment and actually ask me any questions.
Yes. I pass very less urine. Is it okay?
What water do you take, ma'am? I didn't get.
She's saying that she takes barley water.
Yeah, barley water, then even certain, there is something known as, what do you call? I'm just telling. So certain juices are also good. Barley water is not bad, but only thing is, make sure that the amount of fluid intake doesn't become too much.
Okay.
Because at yeah. See, you can take it. You can take it every day. But then the thing is, do you feel that there is any improvement in symptoms?
After taking the water, then I feel I'm fasting. I don't know what it's about.
Okay, but what is the total amount of fluid that you take usually in a day? Yeah, so I think you have to make it a point to at least have minimum 1 liter if you don't have any heart problems or kidney problems.
There's nothing else.
Yeah, so at least you should take 1 to 1.5 liters then, 1 to 1.2 liters, because even less is not good. And then not taking fluid and then taking barley water to pass urine might not be right. So if you take good amount of fluid, then obviously you should be able to pass good amount of urine.
Okay. You said not to have coffee or tea.
Yeah.
I mean, cut down on that.
Now, yeah, you can cut down on that.
Only cut down. But can you have a cup of tea in the morning?
Yeah, you can.
Yeah, you can have maybe one cup.
Yeah, maybe a minimum of 2. But if you are struggling with urinary problems already, then I would limit it to 1. Yeah, then 2 cups are fine. There's a lot of echo.
Just give me 1 second, doctor.
Yeah.
Doctor, can you just the echo is because of the audio call.
Okay.
Hello, I just wanted to know sometimes at the vagina there is a little itching, you know, sort of. What is that due to?
Can you repeat it again, ma'am?
I said sometimes at the vagina there is a little itching. Kind of a thing. Is that okay, or what have I to do for that? Can you hear me?
It has to be good, because there's a chance that there will be an increased dryness. One. And two is also, if at all it sustains, then you should actually be showing it to a gynecologist. Because there are certain creams which will obviously help in better lubrication, and then it will help you in making sure that there is no irritation.
Okay, thank you.
Yeah.
Okay.
Yeah.
But I mean, initially, it's specific cream can do something for the vagina,
no, I think it would. It might not be appropriate to prescribe like that. It was better to get it checked and then do it.
Okay, fine.
Doctor, yeah. There's a query which is there on chat, if you can have a look at it.
Into this.
Doctor, just for everybody else, I'm just going to repeat what the query is so that everybody understands it. Just give me a second. I'll just unmute the audio also. So the query is, the moment I touch cold water to wash my hands, I get a call for urine. Also, whenever I open my eyes during the night, I have to rush to the washroom. Over to you, doctor.
Yeah, so I would say there's a great component of I think mental part in this, because just touching cold water should not induce urination. And of course, a lot of older adults, when they get up in the night, they get the urge of passing. So if at all you're taking fluids after 6 p.m., I would tell you to restrict that to less. One, and two is, when you actually go and get up and you get urine or not is important. Or is it just a feeling? If it is just a feeling, then of course it is mental. If you have to pass significant amount of urine, then we have to take care of the fluid intake.
Thank you, doctor. Just before you, the next question, I just like to...
Again, if Urimax is advised, then it has to be specific for your condition. I mean, Urimax will not work for everybody. For example, for an older adult who has got a prostate problem, that's a male, Urimax can work in because it helps in decreasing the size of the prostate when extracted.
Dr. Prem, she's saying continuous use of the tablet, is that advisable? I assume
yeah,
she's talking about Urimax.
Yeah, see, as far as Urimax is concerned, yeah. If it is, the continuous use, obviously, it has to be monitored. For example, if it is for a male, then yeah, we have to see the ultrasound and see whether there is prostate, whether the size is decreasing. Even females are prescribed this. If it is for a female, then we have to see if the symptoms are there or not improving, reduced, because this is on titration. If that low dose maintaining and your urinary problems are not there, then you can obviously continue it. We can obviously stop and see it also along with a fluid sort of component taken care of. Yeah.
Doctor, just to help you, she asked, are there any dangers for using adult diapers? I think that's another very interesting question. If you could
yeah,
spend
yeah.
a little more time on the adult diaper part.
Yeah, adult diapers are, it's like a very well sort of, there are a lot of companies that are offering it and they're very good in condition. Now, if you say the risk, obviously, maintenance of hygiene is very important. The frequency that you put, most older adults will be putting it when they are going out if they are mobile. Of course, if they're immobile, then the local cleanliness and the cleaning of the part by the caregiver is very, very important. Because obviously that particular area will become wet, and if it is not cleaned properly, especially in an immobile older adult, then obviously it can lead to other things like pressure sore and local infection of the skin, which is something we never want. But if you're mobile and you're just putting it for outside, then there is not much of an issue. Discarding them and local hygiene maintenance is...
I get a massage book or pass through a stool. Is that normal or is something wrong with it? I cannot control my stool. When I go, if I don't run to the loo immediately, I tend to soil my stool.
Okay.
So any thoughts on that?
See, a fecal not controlling of stool is entirely another different topic as well. But a lot of times when you're trying to pass urine, sometimes you can also end up passing stool as well. And it can be, if it happens not very frequently, then it's okay. But if you're having a loss of control on your stool very frequently, then of course it needs to be analyze. Another time, sometimes what it happens is if you are constipated for a long time and then you are using some local tablets or supposed drees, then initially there will be an incontinence of the fecal, and then later obviously, because what happens, the hard stool tends to get impacted. So that's what happens in that. If it's happening very frequently, then you have to have a look at it. But if it's happening very occasionally, when you're having the urge and you're passing both, then that's not much of an issue. No, if you're going out and you're not passing urine for a long time, and then you come home, obviously mentally you are much more comfortable. So you want to pass urine immediately. Like when we are younger, a lot of times we don't even think. And then when we come home, that is when we actually get the urge and you go. But more and more as you grow older, I would say it's better not to tolerate, because your muscles are comparatively obviously more weaker as compared to earlier. And the more you tend to push it, there will be a chance of incontinence. Whereas if you come home and then you pass off, of course, that's because you are in a comfortable place where you are not, a lot of older people and a lot of people, to be very frank, are not very comfortable in going in places except maybe home or other familiar conditions.
doctor. I'd like to wrap this up. Doctor, thank you again very much. You've been doing this for us practically every week for the last 2 months. In case anybody wants to listen to the doctor's previous talks also on all the various topics, is there on our website. You can just go to my website at www.taresocial.com and click in the resources part. All his talks are there on it on an audio format. This talk will also go on it by the end of day. So please feel to use that as a resource for yourself. And I'll send it to you.